Tiger Woods is a world-class athlete, and so I should only hope all my patients respond as do world-class athletes. But what was important about Tiger's response is that he had an accurate diagnosis. His pain, they felt, was coming from a very specific disc in his back and was able to address it. And despite the fact that he had had multiple surgeries before on this disc, this operation allowed them in a safe and sound way to directly unpinch those nerves, stabilize those bones, and in doing that, gave him dramatic immediate relief. And that's something we see quite commonly in this procedure, even for people who aren't world-class athletes.
Anterior, meaning from the front. Lumbar, meaning the lower spine. Interbody, meaning between the bones. And fusion, which means to join together. The Anterior Lumbar Interbody Fusion, or ALIF, as it is commonly known, is a procedure that has been in use for roughly half a century. Here's how it works. A surgeon accesses the spine from the patient's front via natural separations in the muscles, rather than cutting through the bones and major muscles in the back. Then, the damaged disc is removed and replaced with a spacer intended to restore the height between the vertebrae, or spinal bones, limiting the motion between them and relieving the pinched nerves.
Well, I'm an orthopedic spine surgeon, and so after orthopedic residency in New York, I was a fellow at the San Francisco Spine Center, where 25 years ago I began doing anterior lumbar interbody fusions. So I've been doing them for the past 2.5 decades. I've done hundreds of them in my career. They are a procedure that was one of the first minimally invasive lumbar surgeries. Minimally invasive in that it allows you to operate on what's wrong with somebody without having to injure adjacent structures and keep pretty much normal things normal and just try to fix where the patient's pathology is or where the pain is coming from. The key to surgical success is understanding someone's diagnosis. And if your diagnosis is because of an injury to the disc, or what we call a motion segment, where two bones in a disc meet, then this procedure allows us to focus in on that motion segment and fix it and leave everything else alone in a way that other surgeries don't. The technique has improved, it's very effective, and because we're not cutting people's back muscles, they have a much earlier sense of whether they're better. So very often patients who went to sleep with back and leg pain wake up without that pain. They may obviously have pain from where the incision was, but the center of their pain they can perceive already as being much improved from the moment they open their eyes.